Tiffany & Company reported Monday its first quarter net income increased 3%, USA Today reports. The high-end jewelry company earned $83.6 million, or 65 cents per share, for the period ending April 30th. The results exceed Wall Street expectations, and its shares rose 6% in pre-market trading. Tiffany's, with its signature blue gift box, is an indicator of luxury spending. Tiffany & Company sales received boosts from promotional events tied to the company's 175th anniversary, as well as the release of the featured film, The Great Gatsby, for which the company designed the jewelry. In the Americas, sales climbed 6% to $408 million. European sales also increased 6% to $93 million, while sales in Japan rose 2% to $145 million. Fueled by the release of the Fast and Furious 6, which earned $120 million in its opening weekend, the movie industry broke Memorial Day box office records with estimated receipts of $316 million. The latest model in the Fast and Furious line enjoyed the biggest opening weekend ever for the Universal Pictures release, Hollywood.com noted. In addition, its domestic grosses, it earned an addition $158 million internationally. In second place, the box office was the rated R comedy, The Hangover Part 3, which earned $51.2 million. Star Trek Into Darkness, in its second week of release, earned $47 million. All three films are sequels, which have become a typical for summer movie releases. The animated film Epic, a non-sequel, came in fourth with $42.6 million. Valeant Pharmaceuticals, Canada's largest drug maker, said Monday it was purchasing eye care giant Bausch & Lomb from the private equity firm Warburg Pincus. The deal is worth $8.7 billion, CNN reports. Bausch & Lomb, founded in 1853, now employs more than 12,000 people worldwide, providing contact lenses, treatments for eye conditions such as glaucoma, and surgical instruments in more than 100 countries. The company expects revenues this year of about $3.3 billion and adjusted operating profits of about $720 million. Valeant said it was looking to take advantage of a growing demand for eye care solutions generated by an aging population, rising rates of diabetes, and new markets in emerging economies, CNN reports. Reporting from Millionaire Corner, I'm Heather Kiley. Thanks for watching.